Aloha, Photoshoppers. It's your man, Doc Rock. What's up, my internet people? As you know, a few months ago, I made a video showing you how to revert the Photoshop free transform tool back to the old legacy method. Back in about October of 2018, they broke it. Nobody knows why, but I got thousands of comments, hundreds of comments of people saying, thank you. They finally made it go back to the way it was. Compliments to this video that I posted that showed you how to go in and write a preference file that would adjust this. Now, if you are like me and you have auto update turned on, the dumb auto update, you will find out when you woke up the other day and you clicked on Photoshop in version 20.0.5, it was back to broken again. Or was it fixed? Or was it broken? It just depends on how you see it. Let me open this up real quick just to give you an idea. If I grab this brick wall in the modern Photoshop, you can just grab a corner and you pull it and it stays properly proportioned. That was the point of Adobe's update. It's easier. And I would say, yeah, it's kind of easier if you didn't already have 30 years of doing it the other way. I'm sorry, I'm old, curmudgeon. I don't want to learn the new way. I got new cats in my comments that don't want to learn the new way. So, before the update, you were able to fix a preference file and that would adjust it so everything would work. But the meaning of what they want you to do is they want you to hold the shift key when you want to break transform, like such. I'm holding shift key now and I can break transform. But if that's not your swag, you can just touch it, close it, and it works. But again, if that's not you, it's not me. We're going to put it back. But they made it easier. No more coding. For all of the people in my comments who couldn't find the secret hidden folder and turn around 3 times while saying Beelzebub, you don't have to do that anymore. Check it out, folks. Here's a new update in 20.0.5. Command K on this computer. It might be Control K on what you roll. I know you can just go up in the menu here, and under here, you'll see preferences. On the very first tab, under General, there is use legacy transform. There it is, right here in that first row of settings closer to the bottom. Use legacy transform. If you click that and you press OK, now when you grab this, if I hold down the shift key, it does what it should. If I hold down shift in option, it should scale in place as it should. Look, it's working the way we like it. The way that's the old way, or the new old way, or the old way. It doesn't matter. Aloha, folks. We got it back. And thank you to the people in the comments of my old video that was saying, Doc, it's broken. Please help me fix it. Because you forced me to dive in and start reading crap that nobody else wants to read. I'm your dude. I'm the dude who reads stuff. If you don't like to read, press the subscribe button now. Press the bell to be notified in case you don't want to read again. And I read it and I figured it out. Just save yourself some time. I'll be that guy. You pop the beers, I'll do the reading. I got you covered. Plus, subscribe. Thank you so much to my subscribers. And thank you to all the comments from the old video. But I hope this helps you put the old way back to the new old way. It's confusing. Do it how you like it. There are a couple other updates in those options. I'll get to that in a different video. For right now, I just wanted a quick fix to update the Doc Squad on Doc Rock Tips on how to put Photoshop the way you like it. It's almost like Photoshop Burger King. Aloha, people. Mahalo for watching.